Hello guys, welcome back to my 1 to 19 Twink leveling guide. For part 2 of this series, we complete Westfall going from level 11 to 12. Before we start, I wanted to mention there are two items from Westfall that are important. Large rope nets dropped by Murloc Netters, and magic dust dropped by Dust Devils. We start with the Captain Sanders treasure map quest, which begins at level 10. The map itself drops off of Murloc's in Westfall. The quest is a four-part treasure hunt. It rewards the only bind-on pickup shirt for 19s, which is why I like to get it. The real treasure in this quest is that it exemplifies the 19 process I'm trying to convey, which is that you should soak every possible XP gain imaginable, and by doing so, this allows you freedom and all the options available to your character once you are at level 19. We want to avoid the case where you are level 19 and already have a lot of XP nearing level 20, and you are not able to go someplace or be missing an item that you cannot get due to being too close to level 20. Next in Westfall, we go to Deadmines. There are three items I need from here for my shaman. Lavishly jeweled ring off of Gillen, gold-plated buckler off Miner Johnson, who is a rare spawn, and the blackened Defias armor that's dropped by Van Cleef. You see me collecting resources from this dungeon. You can level your engineering nearly all the way to 150 by just picking up resources from this instance. Round 1. No Miner Johnson. No luck with Gilland, and no luck with Van Cleef. You see here I am smelting everything on my main for more bag space. I could also smelt the ore on my 19 if I wanted to level my mining. And then I camp out and reset. Here's the total number of bars I smelted from the ore I collected in just the first instance. Round 2. No Miner Johnson. No luck with Gillen. I bring VC back to Gillen's room. No luck with VC, RIP. Round 3. Again, no luck with Gilland. And Pog, the rare Miner Johnson, drops his shield on its first kill. This is going to save me a lot of time. Now for VC. Corsair's Overshirt. This can be used in a spirit set, but it's not what I'm after. Round 4. Gillen, no luck. Van Cleef drops BDA. I'll take it. Round 5. Gillen, again, no luck. Round 6. Finally, lavishly jeweled ring. That's all I needed from Westfall, so I'm a hearth out of here. I fly to Org and begin leveling my first date. Important to note that I keep going with the green item, but then after 20 or so that doesn't give me a level up, I just train the yellow and use it to level. I forgot to train my weapon skills in part 1 when I first arrive in Org. I'll need to check Undercity Weapon Trainer later. And now we start leveling engineering. I already had some engineering done when I leveled it in Dead Mines. There are some best practices when leveling engineering, such as always ride certain items until they are gray. These items include handful of copper bolts and copper modulators, used in making target dummies, coarse stone blasting powder, used in making aquadynamic fish attractor, which you will use during the STV fishing tournament and is also used to craft heavy shot. Heavy stone blasting powder, used in making big bronze bombs, explosive sheep, and heavy dynamite. Bronze tubes, used in making recombobs and discombobs. Whirring bronze gizmo, used in making recombobs, discombobs, explosive sheep, and flame deflectors. And silver contact, used in making big bronze bombs. But usually I just level it with what's cheapest off the auction house. Here I visit the Shaman Trainer for level 12 spells. I flew my main out to Dust Wallow to pick up the 3 first aid books we'll need. Heavy Silk Bandage Book, Under Wraps, which allows me to go to level 225 first aid, and the Mage Weave Bandage Book. And I finish off my first date. That's it for part 2. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in part 3.